Hello, I'm here in just outside of Thika town with Cyrus Kabiru, Nganga, right? And tell me the name of your space and what is happening here today.
The place is called Art Orodha.
Art what?
Orodha.
Orodha, what does that mean?
Orodha means junk.
Junk.
Yeah. It's a junk, or a list of something. It might be a list of people, a list of something, or other.
How long have you been building this place?
Now like 4 months now. Yeah.
So tell us a little bit about yourself, Cyrus. How long have you been working as an artist?
I'm an artist. I paint, I do sculpts, I do...
You work with found objects, junk?
Yeah, I work with found objects. As you can see here, all artists, they work with found objects.
Now this is not yours, eh? This is by one of your students, eh?
Yeah. So, yeah, most of the artwork here is just for...
Gallery and what else?
No, it's not a gallery.
It's not a gallery.
It's a studio.
It's a studio.
Yeah, but people, they are just hanging their artwork. Just
so
for today.
How many students do you have here?
For now, I have three. But I want more, two more. To be five.
You have space.
Yeah, I have a space that can carry more than five artists.
And you say that you started doing your glasses, which you gave a name to. What's your story? How did that happen?
For the glasses, when I joined Kuona,
yes,
I was doing paintings and sculpting. But separate, I was doing the glasses, but in my house, my home studio.
Now, how did you decide to do glasses?
And when I joined Kuona, a friend of mine, Dennis, Muraguri, told me to bring the glasses to the studio. Because I thought I was doing childish. So I didn't, and you know in my culture, when you're grown up, you're not supposed to do childish. So I used to do them hiding. Because I was grown up. So. Yeah, and I started when I was young.
So Dennis told you to bring, and then what happened? People came to your studio at Kona and liked them?
No, like when I came with them, a friend of mine, she visited, I gave them. I gave her one pair. Basically, I gave her for free, but later she gave me, some money. He gave me 700 Kenya shillings. That's $70.
Yes.
She was the first person
to buy.
But I used to give in school. I used to train. You do my homework, I give
when
you.
When you were in school?
Yeah, when I was in high school. I used to train. You do my homework, I give you a pair.
And they would do your homework?
Yeah. You do my exam, I give you a pair.
So, your glasses have taken you many places.
Yeah, the glasses, they've played big role.
People like them.
People
all
like
over.
Them. Now it's the radio. Radio people love them.
Really?
Yeah, people they are buying them.
Your radios?
Yeah.
Is it still the same idea of putting junk together?
You know, in our village,
yes.
My grandfather was the first person to have the radio in the village. So we have that culture of radios in our village, in our family. So I end up having that radio, and then I redo the radio to be an artistic way.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
And the bicycle is also something about your family.
Yeah, bicycle. My dad used to work with bicycle.
Didn't you say he had a shop on the back of his bicycle?
Yeah. So he used to hawk with the bicycle. So, and I didn't like the bicycles because of him. So that's why I'm making the bicycles.
Your own bicycles.
My own bicycles.
Yeah. But you're turning them into art.
Yeah.
Now, you said you were going to one day make this place into a residency. We were going to have an art residency. How long would that be? Someone would come and stay here and be tutored by you, right? And how long would that be?
The place I'm planning to do a residency. Uh-huh. I want to invite upcoming artists, uh-huh, international artists, uh-huh, professional artists, uh-huh, and not even the artists.
How long?
Whoever want to do a residency, uh-huh, I want this place to be the place to. I'll do it slowly by slowly.
Wonderful.
But it's on a program, uh-huh, of what
it's
I'm
part
doing.
Of the list.
Yeah.
Cyrus, thank you so much. This is a real privilege to be here on this very special day. Thank you.
You're welcome.